And welcome back, everybody, once again to Untold Stories for Corona Trials by Mr. RenderXR. I am TJ the Obscure here with you, and we are still here at the starting area, which, man, I just cannot get over how gorgeous this area is. I absolutely love it, although I've done a bit of damage to it with the water and taking out the tree and whatnot. But it's a very beautiful area. I'm kind of sad to have to leave now. Let's go ahead and light up some fireworks, because we forgot to do that last episode for the pink wool. Whee! Let's light off a bunch of them. Yay! We got the pink wool! Alright, I have to remember to do that after we get the wool each time. So I took the time to get prepared off camera, got some more wood, I made some bread, made a little wheat farm over in that area, and dropped some things off as well in case we happen to die. You might notice that the get the words out of your mouth, guy. The F5 view is a little different. Some people complain, said that it makes them sick, that they can't handle it. And I think it was Moldy who suggested that I try out a third-person mod. So that's what I went ahead and I did. I downloaded the shoulder surfing mod. It's the only one that I could find that was updated for 1.11. So we have our crosshair, so we can actually see where we're attacking and where we're pointing at and whatnot. Another cool thing is that if you're up close against a block, instead of being inside of my head, it just switches to normal view. It can get a little wonky still, especially like in certain circumstances like this one right here. You'll end up kind of switching back and forth really quickly like that. But overall, I think it's much better than the normal F5 view. Especially because you guys won't have to spend time staring at the back of my head. Nor will I. It should make it a little easier, which is not really what I was going for. But I gotta make some trade-offs here, right? Make the viewing experience acceptable and enjoyable for you guys. And in the process, make things a little easier for me. Okay. I think that's all that I needed to tell you guys, but I'm still kind of like, if a lot of people just really do not like it and want me to switch to normal view, then I probably will, and we'll just have to come up with another way of keeping things exciting, I suppose. All right, now we are headed down into this hole here. It's not that far down, but I'm gonna go ahead and give ourselves a proper path, just to be safe. Never know what we might encounter down here. Oh, also, I installed Optifine. I went a little crazy with the mods. I installed Optifine, which I've used before, but not very frequently. I learned a little while ago that it now has dynamic lights. So it enables light-emitting items like torches, glowstone to illuminate everything around them, which I think Minecraft should have had this since the beginning. I know it was hard to implement because it was kind of CPU intensive, but that means that, for example, this torch that I'm holding right now, you can see light goes on, light goes off, light goes on, light goes off. I'm not sure how, I mean, I like it, but I'm not sure how you guys are going to feel about it, so do let me know if you don't like the Optifine stuff. And man, there are just a lot of things that you can play around with. I was not really aware of that. I tried not to play around with too many things, but I got a little crazy. So yeah, I think that's it. I think we're good now. It kind of throws me off though, because I feel like, oh, I've already placed a torch here, but I actually have not placed a torch here. Nope. 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 Bad water. Bad water is bad. I hear the zombie. Left, right, all around. Oh, poor guy. You poor zombie, you. That's not cool. That is not cool whatsoever. I see a light. I see a light. I see a light from a glowstone. Okay. This just looks like a series of caves. I was expecting like a proper area. I don't know which way I want to go now, you guys. Which way should we go? Ooh, that leads outside. Okay, we have coal and a bit of and a chest here as well. I guess we probably want to grab that first. Ooh, lots and lots of the food, some more arrows. And I guess we'll take a couple of those things. Don't really need all of them, though. An anvil would be nice. That's one thing I would really, really appreciate at this point. Although, that we have... an enchanting table already is kind of crazy, right? We got it like right off the bat. I'm gonna go ahead and mine out this coal, and I'll be right back with you guys. All right, and since that pick is getting kind of low, I figured we would go ahead and enchant another one, just so we don't run out. And I think I'll go ahead and switch to it. That way, if we do find an anvil, I can combine them. All right, let's continue on and see what else we can't find. Poor Mr. Zombie Villager. Left. Oh, hello. Hello. That's one thing I notice is that the creepers actually provide light, which is kind of weird. It's kind of weird indeed. I guess that's just one thing that we're going to have to learn to deal with. I don't want to put light down and put water everywhere. So I'm trying to be careful here. Another room full of the coal and a chest. Ooh, and some stone as well. Let's go ahead and put you right there. I'm hoping that'll work. Definitely want the stone. And more food and armor. Ooh, and a shield. Finally, a shield. Yes, please. Yes, please. I will take it. And I don't think we really need the armor. But we will take that stuff. And I do want the stone as well. I'm surprised there aren't like any spawners or anything. It's just caves with natural spawns, it seems. All right, let's keep going. And hopefully we'll get into some danger here soon. Otherwise, I could see this getting kind of boring. I this is probably going to help me save on torches. I tend to place torches everywhere. Ooh, finally a spawner, you guys. Actually, yeah, I think I'm just gonna take it out. I don't want to have to mess with the water and whatnot. I'm surprised it didn't spawn. I already have enough coal. I don't need any more coal. Yeah, I'm kind of surprised nothing. Oh, we're good, right? Yeah, it's on hard. Huh. Oh well, you're there. And now you're not. Thank you for the blocks, Mr. Creeper. Probably do not want that torch there, actually. Because it's going to make... Hey. Go back. It's going to make that water melt. Or that yes, it's going to make the water melt. It's going to make the ice melt. More coal. Another spawner right there. That one did seem to get set off, thankfully. We'll just go ahead and light you up. And I don't think that's going to melt anything. Let's go ahead and get up here quickly. Whoa, that kind of scared me. It looks like it just shot out armor, though. Oh, too many things, you guys, too many things. Curse of Binding. And it has mending. Ouch. That's kind of mean. But thankfully I don't have... Oh, gosh. Thankfully, I wasn't able to pick any of it up. It almost, like, auto-aims, which is interesting. Yeah, I wasn't able to pick any of it up because I already have armor on. That could have been a pretty nasty trap, though. All right, we have an ender chest here. Let's go ahead and put up... Actually, I think I am going to do the thing where I keep all the emeralds on me. Winterbound, Aurora Valley, Morrow Cavern? Morrow Bay, that's actually the beach that I go to, that my family and I went to when we grew up. It's called Morrow Bay. And there's Morrow Rock, which is an old volcano. It's also where I had my honeymoon. Anyways, Chill Blast Mines. Alright, there was more back here, though. I guess we didn't really need to spend the time collecting the stone. It looks like we already have quite a bit of stone here to use. And, of course, guy... Oh, gosh. Nope. Okay, one-shot kill. One shot and you're dead. Hopefully that spawner is well-lit. A staircase, huh? Well, this is making me a little nervous. with a chest, which is making me nervous still. You can borrow my shovel if you want. Okay. I'm guessing this is just a shortcut then back to. Let me inside of the thing, please. Let me inside of the thing. Back to the start. Yes, indeed. I don't know if we'll need to make use of that, but at least we have it now. And do I have. I don't have any zombie flesh on me. So unfortunately, we cannot heal these couple hearts that I have lost without using the bread. I wonder who would not have armor by this point? Like, who would that actually work on? I guess you could have like a piece that's broken or something, but I would think everybody would have armor by this point. And let's just go ahead and put up a lot of our important stuff here. That looks cool right there. That has a really, really cool effect. Except when we stand right there, but. Huh. There's no indication of where we need to go first. I'm assuming we want to go in clockwise direction, though. So we'll head to Aurora Valley first. I think is the correct choice here. We have vines, we have water, we have creeper, and more coal for us as well. And water. I was really hoping this was not going to be a water area, but it is a water area. It's Render said the map is centered around like fire, I think. But I haven't seen any fire yet, you guys. So I hope I did not misunderstand that, because so far it's been like ice. So my title is the Flaming Corona Trials. Is there anything up at the top of this here waterfall? I am curious. Every time I see a waterfall, I want to swim it. I want to go to the top. I'm not sure how I feel about this view, because I'm not like. Oh, there is something up here, you guys. Wow. Usually there's not. In most maps nowadays, there's not anything at the top. So I'm kind of surprised to see that. Projectile protection for unbreaking two. Yes, please. I will take it. Especially with how deadly skeletons can be. Because it's like off-centered now, you know? It's like it's over my shoulder, which I guess is closer to some third-person games, right? Oh, and we fall right down. But it's not, I don't know, it feels weird to me. Witches, right off the bat. And lots of trees and sugarcane and a sign right here. Let's see if we can read the sign. By the way, don't waste your time with reeds. They are just for show. Whoa. That kind of reminds me of the one area from Myriad where it's like with all the invisible blocks. Oh, there's fire. Fire! And lots. Gosh, what's with all the freaking rain, you guys? I would love for the rain to go away, please. I'm guessing we want to go down. Whoa, those reeds look weird right from this view. Yeah, that's my guess. We want to go down, right? Or maybe we want to go up and around right here. It's not entirely clear which direction we want to go. I will say that the view makes traversing landscapes significantly harder. We probably want to go both up and down, right? Can we get up on top? We have creeper dudes. Whoa, how'd you hit me from through the thing, guy? You're so very talented. Magical spider. Magical spider can hit me through the walls. And let's get up here as well. There's the spawner. And there is the mob. Back up, back up, back up. And you're still not dead yet for some reason. Is there a creeper spawner or... Oh, there's a chest right here. I will take it. Oh, an iron sword. Chain boots. Blocks. Wood. All the things that we need, you guys. All the things that we need. Let's just go ahead and take one of these mushroom stews. Like a so. I would like to go back and enchant some of this stuff, but... It seems kind of weird to already be going back, right? We just got here. We just showed up, and you're already going to leave? How very rude. How so very rude. This area, man. Wow. I love the layout of the area. It's so not linear, right? There's all kinds of things to explore and places to go. Oh, and there's Furnai. Anything in the Furnai? Does not look like it. How are you able to make such amazing maps in such a short time, Render? Does it have something to do with your simple style? That's what I would like to know. Bunk. Ooh, wait, did that open something? It sounded like that opened something. Well, what did that open? Right? Or is that just... Is that just the sound that these make now? Am I just out of the loop? Oh, no, there is something back there. I think that's just from copy-pasting. If I had to guess. Hoo-wee. So many things. So very many things. Oh, and a bucket. Wow. Okay. We are good to go. We can beat the map now. Beat the map with the bucket. Nothing in the closet. I haven't ever really tried... Actually, I did have to do water drops while in F5 mode when I was playing the Painter, I think, in the Red Wool area. And it's not easy. It is not easy to do water drops while you're in F5 mode. Let's see if there's anything further in this direction, or maybe we can get a better peek at the area. Water and stone... And stuff like that. It looks like we probably do want to head down there eventually, but let's try to stay up top while we can. I think I see mushrooms right there. Is what those are. And let's just dig a little path through here. I'm waiting for like a skeleton spawner or something. I gotta keep reminding myself that this map is supposed to be really easy, so I shouldn't expect too many challenges, especially not in an early area like this one. I think I want to keep heading back in this direction. Right, there's a chest right there. Is there a zombie spawner around? Or are you natural? Are you natural or artificial, Mr. Zombie? Well, whatever you are dead now. That's what matters. Ooh, infinite wood. Infinite wood. Oh gosh, you got that knockback resistance. You got the knockback resistance. Lots of darkness over here. And there's a little baby as well. Let's just say no to those guys for right now. No thank you, do not feel like fighting you. I feel like I am heading in the right direction. Oh, hello. Hello, I did not see that. Thankfully you guys alerted me to your presence. Waiting for the baby to sneak up on me. Okay. Oh gosh. I don't know how I'm managing to do this, but I am! Oh, maybe I'm not. Hit the baby. I can't hit the babies. There we go. Okay, we're okay. Ooh, that was weird. I felt like I should have been hitting him, but I was not. Let's get away from that evil place. I think it's a good idea. And, oh gosh, I'm in the water. That's problematic, I think. Because that's really annoying. That is really annoying indeed. Hopefully there aren't too many water areas. There's definitely something up right there. Let's take out this zombie and then go check out this cave. Maybe, hopefully. And running through the sugar canes is also kind of annoying. Gosh dang it. Go, go, go! Ooh, this sword is about to break. How are you guys spawning so quickly? I guess because there's two of you, huh? We have an emerald now. Yeah, aiming directly down is kind of difficult. Oh, we'll go ahead and put you right there. Oh, you can see through the world. This will make a lovely zombie farm if we happen to need it. Let's head up this other waterfall next. Thankfully, I have lots of food, right? So if I take a bit of damage here and there, it shouldn't matter too much. My armor is looking okay. Up, up, and away. I don't know why this. I love like this kind of stuff. This is. It looks so cool, you guys. It looks so freaking awesome. And up here we have darkness. Lots and lots of the darkness. Looks like there might be a doorway right there. Any secrets in the water? Does not look like it. That is not a doorway. Oh, it goes up. It goes up. Good to know. Good to know. Creepy noises. Creepy noises. Not a good sign. Not a good sign whatsoever. I'm gonna have like already found the path to the next intersection or something. Watch. It looks like that might actually be the case. What in the heck is this, you guys? What in the heck is this? Press button for shortcut. Yes, indeed. It looks like we've already found the path to the next intersection. Well, that was easy. First intersection complete. Just kidding, of course. All right, I don't know how I managed to do that. I always seem to go places I'm not supposed to be yet. Clearly, we need to spend some more time out in this area. And we need to beat the entire intersection first before we move on. Mushrooms. The mushrooms are making me kind of curious. We probably want to head over to that giant house over there, I would think. Would make the most sense. And I see the creepers coming for us. I see all of the things. Let's head in here first, I think. It's going to be a smart decision. Go ahead and close the door, light it up. This looks familiar. I know these houses. These houses are from Myriad, actually. Same design and everything. That's how you're able to do these so quickly, huh? Just copy-pasting everything. I know your tricks. I know your tricks, guy. Well, that's lovely, but I don't have an anvil. So I don't really know what you want me to do with those. Bed. And at least one of the buildings in Myriad Caves, there was a secret passage in these houses. Can we go ahead and do something like that so that we can kill the Enderman? Give me a pearl, guy. Oh, gosh, my sword broke. I was like, why am I not killing him? That's like 12 shots. Hey, we got a pearl. Thank you very much. Yes. There used to be a secret passage in one of these. Oh, well, whatever. Let's head back down. I definitely want those books. I just don't have the inventory space for it at the moment. There's a hole in your house now, people. Hope you don't mind. Hope you like it a little breezy. And ferni that are empty. More houses. Let's go into the little one first, I think, is a good plan. And we will close the door behind us, because we are polite. We were raised with manners. See how the crosshair kind of trains on them, so you can kind of get a sense if you're actually aiming it for them or not. The babies seem to move slower in F5 mode. I don't know if I'm just the one seeing that, or if everybody's seeing that. So does the ambient light, does it affect spawners? I would think it does, right? Oh man, so many good things, you guys. Resistance. Okay, what can I put up? What don't I desperately need? I guess we can consolidate those guys, right? I definitely want the resistance and the speed, I think, for now. And we have zombies up top, I have a feeling. Oh, there's an emerald right there. You guys see it? I see it. I sees it. And how many emeralds are there? There's 20, 24 emeralds, I think. Something like that. 27, 24. Okay, let's go ahead and just stick you up for now. Oh, gosh, my levels. I already have so many of the levels. So many of the levels. Bucket back on the bar. It's possible that there is still a secret passage in here, but I'm going to guess that it's in one of the other ones. If there is indeed still a secret passage at all. And that's the potions, yes. And we have a switch that does nothing. Let's get out here. We have access to potatoes now. I'm going to go ahead and steal your water. Let's go ahead and shut that door. Oh, gosh. Okay, you do that then. I'm going to just hide in the house. I'm just going to hide in the house. Close the door. Close the door, guy. Close the door. Thank you. Thank you. You did it. Good job. Well done. I knew as soon as I placed the torch, I was like, why am I placing torch on the sand? This is a big patch of sand. And most likely, it is going to end up exploding on us. So why are you doing that, guy? Why? Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. I can't see you. I can't see you. I saw you explode. That's all that matters. I saw the creeper explode. Go ahead and take you out. Is this... Uh-oh. Is this the secret passage? What are you doing back there, guy? Go ahead and make sure things are well lit. More of this stuff? Gosh dang it. People. We will just get all the levels. Have there been books, bookshelves? If, no, this is not, I thought this was a staircase, but this is just, this is just the roof, right? Oh, hello. Hello there, guy. And more of you, huh? More of the creepers. Then down you go. Alright, I think that's the only house we have yet to go inside, correct? Yeah, the potatoes we definitely want to get. Oh, there's another cave right there, you guys. Shall we test out... Look at all the creepers. It's a creeper pool, you guys. And all the spiders, too. Okay, I'm kind of tempted to just bridge over to this house and take it from the top down, but yeah, let's test out our first water drop. I think will be fun. Hey, I got it. I got it. Well done. Well done, good sir. Okay, everybody's here. Everybody is here. Let's back up a little bit. Take them out. I love how you guys light up whenever I hit you. It's freaking hilarious. What? Okay. Did not work. Did not work. I thought he was ready to die, but he was not ready to die. And sword. Sword, you better last me, sword. Okay, everybody's dead. Everybody is dead. Let's go ahead and regen the health. Oh gosh, you guys are in here. I did not know you were going to be in here, but you are in here. I need to close that door. This is what I need to do. Are you stuck, guy? You're acting like you're stuck. Regen the healths. Regen more of the healths, please. I would like all the health regen. Let's just go ahead and close you off. And you as well. Gosh, dang it. It's showing that I'm targeting you. Alright, and you're closed. And let's get some light down. And up, up, and away we go. I see a chest, maybe. I'm making the music. Making all the music. Nope, nothing here. But keep an eye out for buttons. Buttons and switches. Nope, doesn't look like there's anything in this one. Let's start with you, Mr. Zombie. You're having a hard time there, aren't you? You can't even make it out the door. Okay. I guess let's switch to some better blocks. Definitely want that on the bar. I think is a good option. And yeah, man, a lot of this stuff I think we're just going to have to come back for. It would make a lot of sense to simply go ahead and go back and do enchanting and whatnot. Kill all of the zombies. There's a lot of you guys in there. Why do I feel like the cap for the spawner was not put on? It's almost what it seems like. Because at most, they should be able to spawn like 4 or 5 in this little room, right? That's what I would think. Okay, we'll just light you up. And I think that just leads us outside, so we'll leave that alone for now. Creeper! Creeper, Mr. Creeper. Why do you give up on me so easily, Mr. Creeper? Alright, you are taken care of, and it looks like there's nothing else in here. Nothing hidden under the staircases. And nobody's trying to, like, break down the door or anything. Button. Button does nothing. Alright, let's go ahead and eat, and then make a run for it. Run, run, run away. Ooh, there's lots of you guys. There we go. Everybody burn up. Everybody die. Just like a so. Okay, so we can either go up and across via the mushroom thing, or we can head into this cave. I feel like the cave is going to be a good option here, right? And armor is looking okay. Just okay, though. Not looking perfect. Bam, you're dead. We got a nice creeper farm here, too. If we would so like it, and sand to make all the TNT in the world. Well, there we go. I think I want to put that guy right there, just to be safe. I see the spawners. And they're making me a little nervous. You know what? I think I am gonna go back to base right now and do some enchanting. We still haven't found an anvil yet, as far as I know. But enchant up like the chain gear. That way I can get some actual room in my inventory for stuff. I'm not sure how I feel about the thing with the emeralds being in my inventory. I have a feeling that's just going to end up being really annoying for everybody involved. Oh gosh. Big lag spike there. Very, very big lag spike. All right, I don't like where I am right now. So, anyways, I'll be right back and then we'll check out that cave. And after that, the episode will probably be just about over. So, I'll be back with you guys here shortly. All right, once again, let's try to light up this tree down here and see if there are any secrets or anything. There are creepers. That is for certain, and Endermen. Creepers and Endermen. And exploding creepers. I thought for sure there was going to be something behind this gravel right here. But I don't think that's the case. I do not think that is the case. Let's just, I don't really need to eat that right now. I keep getting my hunger mixed up. Oh no, there is something in there, you guys. Do we see the light? Where are you at there, guy? There you are. And you guys can die as well. Wasting all my arrows here. Where'd you go, Mr. Enderman? I would like to kill you, please. If you can handle that is. Where you at there, guy? Look him in the eye. Look him in the eye. Come to me, my Enderman friend. Oh, is it because there's water right there? Really? Really, guy? You can't just make it across, huh? Does that mean I can just kill you right here? I mean, I know you can teleport. But I can always just hop in the water, too. Alright, no pearl, unfortunately. I'm guessing this is just gonna be another emerald. Another emerald. Or maybe not. Maybe not. This is Tune of Blessing. Fortune and looting. Wow. I will take it. Yes, please. Yeah, by the way, I found emeralds 4 and 5. Clearly, we were not supposed to come here first, right? I think that is the lesson that we have learned. How do I get back up to the buildings? Yep, I keep eating food just because I see my hunger is down, and I just want to eat. I just want to eat all the things, please. Maybe we should try to take a speed potion here and have a bit of fun. Ooh, wait, a speed and a jump potion, maybe. How does that... Is this the... I think this is the one that had the potions in it, right? I think so. Hey, that furnace is backwards. Oh, I thought maybe it was going to be a secret. Is there a secret behind it, maybe? Nope. Nope, nothing there. Because we have all these feathers, the gravel is actually going to be helpful. It's turning night again. In fact, let's go ahead and light these guys up sufficiently. Just so we don't have to deal with them anymore. What was I saying? I have no idea what I was saying. I was saying something. Oh well. Whatever. Oh yeah, the gravel, because we have all those feathers. So we're going to want the gravel for flint so that we can make lots and lots of the arrows. Alright, speed potion. And jump potion. And why are you not... Oh, that's zoom in? Oh gosh, that's usually my throw button. Good to know. Good to know. And let's go fast. Let's go fast and have some fun. Go fast and have all of the funds. I'm guessing that is what we want to see. Ooh, lapis. There's lapis for us. Lapis and iron as well. Let's just go ahead and do something like that. And I think we're relatively safe here. They can still hit us through the corners, of course. We have... No, not a wool. Just a enchanting table and lapis, which we actually need. And we can do higher level enchants now as well. So that's good. That is good to know. It can't decide what it wants to aim at. Oh gosh, he came out of nowhere. Alright, let's go ahead and eat some bread. I guess we don't really need to spend that much more time in here, right? But we can light things up sufficiently. So that whenever we want to come back, it shouldn't be too hard. And you as well. Man, I was really hoping to get a wool this episode. But I'm not sure that's going to happen, you guys. I don't need to eat. It doesn't do anything for your hunger, guy. You do not need to eat. Okay. Well then. I feel like this episode is getting so long, but I want to make some progress here. I would like to make all the progress, please. Oh, I can't go up. It's not allowing me to jump 2 blocks, just 1.5 blocks. Let's keep going in this direction, I think is a smart plan. I don't need to eat. Gosh, dang it. Why do I keep doing that, you guys? It's freaking annoying. It is very, very annoying. Mushrooms. Oh, I thought the spawner was in the tree. The spawner is in the mushroom, though. Let's go ahead and take you out there, guy. I see torches on the tree right there. Maybe we can hop over and see what that's all about. Okay. Okay, we'll just block you off. It looks like... that is most likely going to be the magenta wool right there. Let's go ahead and eat and see if we can take out some of these guys. As long as we're not in range of their spawners and whatnot. Hello there, Mr. Skeleton. I do not see you. Oh, I'm firing at a tree. I'm trying to kill the tree. Somehow I hit you. I'm not sure how I did it, but I did. And you can die. Where's everybody at? There's still a creeper following me. Come here, Mr. Creeper. You're going to be my friend. You're going to be my friend. Thank you. Ha! Everybody's dead. Everybody's dead but me. That's what matters. And you are taking out... Is it just the one spawner? Really? I feel like somebody's coming for me. I feel like somebody is coming for me. Alright, magenta wool has been gotten. We have our fireworks as well. Let's go ahead and get out of this nasty, nasty place. I think we want to be going this way, maybe. And just go fast, 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 fast. Mushrooms. Arrows flying past my face. Alright. And I don't need to eat. I need to keep reminding myself to not eat. I may want to head up to the top of the houses as well. Okay. Gosh, I love this area, you guys. Are these supposed to be like the Northern Lights? That's cool. I love this area. Do not fall off the edge, guy. Please do not fall off the edge. So we managed to get another wool. We managed to get some bookshelves for our enchanting table. We managed to find the path to the next intersection. We also managed to get iron, a bucket. I mean, we accomplished a lot this episode. I'm probably going to end up turning that into a creeper farm. We have access to potatoes now as well. So all in all, a rather successful episode. Be sure to let me know how you feel about the third-person view mod, just about the series in general. Anything you would like to see me do, or something that's really getting on your nerves. That looks like it could be... It almost looks like a creeper face, doesn't it? Or am I just seeing things? I think I'm just seeing things. And he forgot about us? Of course he did. Oh gosh. Okay. Why? Okay, now there is stuff there. Golden apples and a diamond shovel. Let's go ahead and put some of that down. Oh, so many things. So very many things. Go ahead and do that. And that. And I'm just going to go ahead and use these guys right now, I think is what I'm going to do. All right, you guys. I think that's going to be it for me for today. Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed. And I will see you next time.